Over the past hour, he'd sorted the contents of Connie's tin into piles and had begun to piece together the relationships that existed between the so-called Lucky Six. In total, the borough of Bowster had supplied 84 men for the 2nd Battalion Herewitshire Rifles. Of that number, only Henry Tremblett, John Hakesley, Edward Pank, Bernard Craddock, James McFarland, and Reginald Quisenberry had come home. Three of them had then died during the 1980s flu pandemic, but Tremblett, Hakesley, and Pank, despite all contracting the virus, had made it through. Tremblett and Hakesley had been best friends during the war and remained so afterwards, exchanging letters on a frequent basis. But neither of them had maintained any contact with the third survivor, and it was easy to see why. Edward Pank had been an unpopular figure even before the war. He had been Sir Rufus Warne's head gamekeeper and unofficial enforcer, and his reputation for bullying and brutality was unsurpassed. If the stories were true, his punishment of poachers had been particularly savage. One contemporary account claimed that he had once thrashed an emaciated man so badly that his shoulder blades had broken through the skin. When the call to war had come, the gouty and infirm Sir Rufus had served his time in Whitehall, but he had insisted that the gamekeeper be assigned to his younger brother Jolyon as batman and personal bodyguard. Consequently, Pank had not seen any real action, and the fact that he had also been promoted in the field to sergeant soon led to an uncomfortable us-and-them situation developing between him and the 2nd Battalion. It was even rumoured that he was a kind of éminence grise, and that Jolyon took his advice on most subjects. But then had come the disastrous second Battle of Ypres, during which Jolyon's poor decision-making had caused terrible loss of life among his own troops.